I have the Redmi Note 13 Pro here, and in today's video, I'll be showing you how I remove all of the unwanted applications that Xiaomi has pre-installed on this device. Not only will this work on the Pro variant that I have here, but this will also work on the base model, the Redmi Note 13 Pro Plus, the Redmi Note 13 R, and the others that also share this same naming scheme. The focus of this video will be using a program called Universal Android Debloater Next Generation, but if you have the original release still working on your PC, then you could use that one instead. However, I have also previously shown how this can be done directly on the device with the help of an application called Canta. So I'll talk about that method toward the end of this video. To begin, we first need to enable developer mode on the Redmi Note 13 Pro here. So this is done by opening up the Settings application, then tapping on the My Device option. From here, we're going to tap on the detailed info and specs. And then we're going to be tapping on the OS version card about 7 to 10 times. You'll want to look at the bottom here until it tells you that you are now a developer. With that done, we can find this hidden developer options menu by going back to the main settings page and then scrolling all the way down to the bottom until you see the additional settings option. Then from here, we can look toward the bottom again, and you should see that newly revealed developer options menu. From the developer options page, you will need to enable USB debugging mode. So you're going to scroll through this list until you find the USB debugging toggle, and then we're going to tap on that to enable it. Now we will get this danger screen right here, but we're just going to tap on the I'm aware of the possible risks, and then confirm by tapping on the red OK button. If everything went smoothly, you should see that toggle stay enabled right here. Once we have that enabled, we then need to download this debloater tool to our PC. And I'll have this GitHub page linked in the video description below, so you'll just want to scroll down until you find the releases, and then download the latest version that matches your operating system. So for Windows, we're going to download that zip file. If you have Linux, you can download that version instead, or macOS, you can grab that one. Now, once that zip file has been downloaded to your PC, the file needs to be extracted so that we can then run the .exe file or whatever executable file that you need for the operating system you're using. And one last thing, I recommend going ahead and installing a third-party keyboard application on your device from the Google Play Store. I installed Gboard, but if you're a fan of SwiftKey or any other popular keyboard app, then go ahead and install it and enable it right now. This is something that I recommend before debloating the device here, as I have seen these debloaters disable the native keyboard in the past. So having a third-party keyboard installed will make it so that you have a way of typing just in case your native keyboard gets removed. So as a recap, We have developer mode enabled on the Redmi Note 13 Pro Plus. We have then enabled USB debugging mode. And I am now connecting it to the PC with a USB cable. We have the Universal Android Debloater Next Generation program open. And after we connected the phone to the PC with that USB cable, we were asked to grant USB debugging mode access. So I have granted that on my device. So with this program open and the phone connected, we can go ahead and click this refresh button that will find the device that we have plugged into our PC. And it's going to list a bunch of apps here. We are only going to be doing a minimal debloating here. So we're going to be using the recommended list from this dropdown. Once the recommended option has been selected, we're then going to select all from this page. So with all of these recommended apps selected, we have over 130 apps that we are going to uninstall from our default user account. So we're going to click on the review selection. We get a list of all the recommended ones that we're going to be removing. And we're going to click on the apply button right here. You'll see them being removed one by one as they're uninstalled from the default user account here. And you may even see the application icons disappearing from the home screen of your Redmi Note 13R. We want to wait until this is done before we touch the phone or unplug that USB cable. It can take some time. Remember, we're removing over 130 apps that are either bloatware, system apps we don't need, Adware, everything that has been recommended for our specific device. Once you see all of them disappear here, then you know that the tool is done. And now that the Universal Android Debloater program has gotten rid of the more difficult ones, I recommend going to your home screen to uninstall or delete any of them that have been left behind. We can do that by finding an app that we don't use and then performing a long press gesture on the icon itself. Then we can tap on that trash icon and then select uninstall. We do that one at a time for all of these remaining apps that we see here that we do not care to use. Some of these will be deleted instantly, while others give you a confirmation prompt that you saw here. The apps you remove here will depend on if you want to use them anymore. So for example, I don't care to use any themes on this device. So I'm going to tap on the theme store and remove that because I simply don't need it. The same thing for the music app. If I have a music app that I like and don't want the one that's pre-installed, I'm just going to go ahead and uninstall it. So go through all of these app icons on the page, from within this folder, and even on this page. If you don't want an app, we can simply remove it and get rid of it. Earlier, I mentioned that you can debloat the Redmi Note 13 series directly on the device instead of connecting it to the PC and using the program that I highlighted here. I chose to do that method since it's quicker for me. You saw how quickly those apps were uninstalled. However, I understand that not everyone has access to a computer for this specific task. So I have previously done a video about an application called Kanta. This app can be installed via GitHub or on F-Droid, and it does not require root access. However, it does need Shizuku in order for it to work, which does require some setup for it to load properly. So, in an attempt to prevent this video from being longer than it needs to be, I'll be sure to link to that dedicated guide that I have already done down in the video description below. That will show you how to get Shizuku set up, and it'll show you how to get Kanta installed, as well as how to use Kanta to remove those unwanted apps. The idea is the same though. You'll load up the application and you'll be able to uninstall the apps that are recommended through that list. Xiaomi feels the need to pre-install so many applications on many of their smartphones and tablets. With them selling the hardware at such an affordable price, I can honestly kind of understand why. Some of these can be installed very easily from the home screen, so there's no need to use the Debloater to get rid of a lot of them. However, others are classified as system applications and don't even show up on the home screen. And these tend to be much more difficult to remove. Thankfully though, the Universal Android Debloater program is able to remove these very quickly. As long as we select the recommended list, they tend to be removed quite safely as well. Just remember to have an extra keyboard installed just in case the primary one gets removed. And let me know if you ran into any issues during this process down in the comment section below. Please remember to like this video while also subscribing to the channel for more Redmi Note 13 content like this.